Hello, welcome to a new episode. Today's topic is data preprocessing, missing data and transformations. One of the objectives is to explore the different ways of processing the missing data. We'll apply transformations to the data as part of the so-called preprocessing. Preprocessing is the preparation of the raw data before we apply the actual statistical method. Missing data. For example, a dataset may look like following. Usually, the different variables are organized as columns, and the different observations are organized as rows. We may have one or more values missing from the dataset, as we can see here. The complete case refers to the complete rows, so the shaded cells are the complete case. Often, we want to keep only the complete rows by eliminating those which are not complete. Now, all the rows are complete, but the dataset is smaller in size than the original. Instead of just throwing away the incomplete rows, how about making the most out of what is available? So, we may want to fill the missing data by some reasonable criteria. This process is called imputation. One of the ways of filling the missing data is to use the column average. Here we have an example. It seems like a reasonable method. Another way is to pick random values within the same column to fill the missing data. Here you can see an example. Finally, we can also fill the missing data by linear interpolation. This is basically the same as taking the average of the neighboring cells up and down. Transformations. Let's suppose that we have a raw data like this. We can see that the columns have different scales and centers. The first column has small variations centered around 0, while the second column seems to be centered around 100. The third and the fourth columns have larger variations, as we can see. In some cases, it is preferable to match the scales and the centers of the variables. So, we may want to standardize. This means subtracting the column average from each value and then dividing by the standard deviation. After the standardization, the dataset looks like this. Now, the columns have the same scale and center. Another way of matching the scales of the variables is the so-called normalization. From each value, the column minimum is subtracted, and then the difference between the maximum and the minimum of the column is divided. After the normalization, the dataset looks like this. Now, all the values lie between 0 and 1. Another common method of data transformation is the application of the logarithmic function. The question is, why do we want to do it? Suppose that all of the data values are non-zero positive numbers. Also suppose that the distribution of the data values is heavily skewed to the right. This means that the distribution has a long tail extending far to the right. We may want to compress the long tail and make the distribution look more normal, and the logarithmic transformation does precisely that. Let's see some examples. We have this Excel file with data. Suppose that we like to fit the logistic regression coefficients. As usual, we go to PrimaXL, logistic, and then fit. And then fill out the form. We can notice some missing values in the dataset. In the menu form, we press this button named Preprocess to bring up the setup menu. Now, we check on the complete case box and then press exit. We can notice that the pre-process button is active in red. Then we press the run button. We can see that there is a new sheet named Data Complete. Here, the incomplete rows have been eliminated from the dataset. Back to the preprocessing setup menu. Let's check on this box to fill the missing values. In this case, we select random pick from the existing values. By the way, let's also do some transformations. We check on the normalization box and exit. When we press the run button, we have the result. We can notice a couple of new sheets, one named Data Field and another named Data Transformed. The missing values have been filled and the transformation was applied to the dataset. Now, with the same dataset, suppose that we would only like to fill the missing data. So, we go to PrimaXL and press Missing Data. Here, we specify the data range and the method. We select to fill the missing values with a random pick. Also, we check on this box to show in red the filled values. Then, we press the run button. Great! Finally, a summary. Today, we did an overview of the pre-processing with PrimaXL. We saw how to deal with the missing data and how to do transformations. We also did standalone missing data processing. Great! I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Thank you so much. Until next time. Bye.